audience of token is one of the most important yet often overlooked notions that's causing a lot of security issues. In this episode, you're going to learn about this very important concept. So, what's the audience of a token? It's the intended final recipient of the token. In the case of access token, it's a resource endpoint. For refresh token, it's a token endpoint. And the same is true for the code. For ID token, it's the client. As you can see from this, access token is not intended to be interpreted in any sense by the client. That means you cannot use an access token to log the user into the client. The only token that can be consumed by the client among them is ID token. You could potentially design a resource endpoint that returns the information about the user that's using the user agent. In that case, you could use the access token to log the user in after verifying the endpoint response. But you have to make sure that endpoint is under the contract that's only returning the information about the current user, and the payload contains the user's permanent identifier and the audience that is set to the client. Note that an email address doesn't work as the identifier in general, as it's prone for the reuse. At the end of the day, you pretty much end up as designing something that's very similar to ID token. Then, what's the point of designing such a non-interoperable endpoint? You'll be much better off using ID token through the OpenID Connect. In summary, if the piece of software is interpreting a response, such as a token, it's very important to check the audience. If there's no audience information, assume that's not for you and use it with caution. That was 2 minutes. Hopefully this was useful. And before you go, please do subscribe to this channel if you haven't yet.